I'm Melissa McAfee, the Special Collections Librarian, and I'm delighted to show you our culinary collection today. Not everything in our collection is rare and old, but oftentimes derives their significance from being part of a collection. And this is the case with the Culinary Collection. It's a collection of 20,000 cookbooks dating from the 17th century to the end of the 20th century. It also includes ephemera and the papers of Canadian food writers. Although we certainly get a lot of people locally, we get people from all over the world who come to see this collection. The collection has been primarily used by scholars who are researching food history. It's also used a lot by people who are really into food, as well as chefs. We've had chefs from all over Canada come to look at this collection. And more recently, the collection has been the focus of exhibits and digital humanities projects that are curated by students at the University of Guelph. Well, this is a reprint of the 1932 edition of the Futurist Cookbook, which was written by Tommaso Marinetti in 1932. So the purpose of the cookbook was to totally transform Italian cooking. Marinetti really wanted it to be more joyful and dynamic. He was promoting things such as food sculptures, spraying perfume between courses, and short little poems and bits of music to enhance the joy of eating. This is the 1949 edition of the Margine Recipe Cookbook. It was produced by the Canada Packers to advertise some of its products, including margarine, which had been banned in Canada until 1948. The cookbook is written by a fictional character, sort of like a Betty Crocker of the US. She was invented by the Canada Packers to advertise their cookbooks. One of the strategies for this advertising cookbook to get people to buy margarine was to promote it as a healthy food. And on this cover, you can see very prominently that it contains large doses of vitamin A and D. The other thing that I think is really interesting about this is that they got the stamp of approval of the Chatelaine Institute, which tested and approved all the recipes in this cookbook. It was designed by A.J. Casson, who, as a lot of people know, is a very important Canadian artist and was part of the Group of Seven. This is the 1684 edition of The Queen-Like Closet by Hannah Woolley. Books of this era not only include recipes for food, but also receipts for medicine to cure a lot of ailments, including the plague.